Let's discuss what is biasing. There are three modes of operation of BJT. They are saturation, cutoff and active. So biasing is required to select any one of the mode of regions of operation. Now let's discuss the need for biasing. The first need for biasing is to select operating point. Operating point is nothing but the value of collector current and its respective VCE. So while selecting a particular IC and its VCE, we can select one of the regions of operation of transistor, saturation, ya phir cutoff, ya phir active. So operating point is used to indicate the mode of regions of operation of BJT. The second need for biasing is to maintain this operating point which is selected earlier. And the third need for biasing is to avoid thermal runaway. Now we will discuss what is thermal runaway in short. We know that IC current, which is collector current, is related with beta IB, where beta is the current gain of the transistor and IB is the base current of the transistor. This is due to the majority charge carriers. Beta IB is flowing due to majority charge carriers. If we consider the current due to minority charges, it is ICO. ICO is the leakage current flowing in the reverse bias junction. So in short, IC is equal to beta IB plus ICO. Now when IC increases in this relation, IC is increasing, so IB is also increasing. And with the increase in IC, the temperature of BJT also increases. The temperature of BJT increases because as we know that when current जब भी conductor के through current flow होता है तो वहाँ पे temperature या heating effect is seen. तो इसका मतलब ये है कि temperature is rising. तो IC अगर बढ़ता है तो temperature बढ़ेगा और temperature affect करता है minority charges को. तो when temperature is increasing, ICO is going to increase. So with ICO increased, the IC is also getting increased. और IC बढ़ते वक्त temperature बढ़ता है. तो this effect is कि IC बढ़ा तो temperature बढ़ा तो ICO बढ़ा और ICO बढ़ने की वजह से IC further बढ़ जाता है. तो ये cumulative action इतना ज़्यादा हो जाता है कि temperature goes so high that it can burn the BJT. So this effect is known as thermal runaway. This is thermal runaway. There is no saving of the BJT. अगर thermal runaway होता है तो BJT जल ही जाता है. तो we have to design a biasing circuit which avoid this thermal runaway. This is a fixed bias circuit. This is one of the technique of biasing a transistor. This is the transistor. Collector is connected to RC. This is the collector resistance. Base is connected to RB. And emitter is grounded. Here, emitter is directly grounded. This point is given to VCC. Battery source is connected here. The current through base is IB and current through collector is IC. Now we have to find the operating point here. The operating point is given by the value of IC and its respective VCE. So now we will try to find out what is the IC of the circuit and what will be its respective VCE. Now voltage across these two points, base and emitter ke beech mein jo voltage drop ho raha hai junction mein, it is known as VBE, and VCE is the voltage between collector and the emitter of the transistor. So while calculating IC, I know IC is equal to beta IB. So first I need to calculate what is IB. To know IB, I will apply KVL in the input loop. अब इनपुट लूप कैसा है, VCC से स्टार्ट होगा थ्रू RB, RB के थ्रू और बेस, देन टू एमीटर से ग्राउंड. सो दिस विल बी द लूप वी विल बी फॉलोइंग, एंड यहाँ पे मैं केवल लगाऊंगी और केवल मुझे मिलेगा VCC माइनस IB RB, द वोल्टेज ड्रॉप इन RB माइनस द ड्रॉप इन द जंक्शन is equal to zero. So IB will be, with this we can calculate IB. This is the base current. Now I know what is IC. IC is beta IB. So I, with this I can calculate IC. IC I have calculated. Now I will apply KVL in the output loop. Ab output loop will look like this. हमारा जो आउटपुट लूप है, केवल हम VCC से शुरू करके थ्रू RC थ्रू द कलेक्टर ऑफ द BJT एंड द एमीटर, हम ऐसे केवल इक्वेशन बनाएंगे. द इक्वेशन विल रिजल्ट हियर. दिस इज माय इक्वेशन, दिस इज माय थर्ड इक्वेशन. VCC माइनस IC RC ड्रॉप इन RC माइनस द ड्रॉप इन वोल्टेज बिटवीन collector and emitter is equal to zero. From this I know VCE is equal to VCC minus IC RC. Now I know VCC, I know IC, I know RC. I can calculate VCE. So the second coordinate of the operating point we have calculated. So now we can say that मुझे operating point मालूम है इस circuit का. Now let's see the potential divider biasing. This is the potential divider bias. There are two biasing resistance, R1 and R2. RC is the collector resistance and RE is the emitter resistance. So to solve this, we have to solve this circuit, and we have to make a simple circuit which is known as Thevenin's circuit. This circuit is the Thevenin's equivalent of the upper one, this one. Here RTH is calculated by using the value of R1 and R2, which are parallel combinations. So RTH in this circuit is equal to R1 parallel to R2, which is equal to R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2. And VTH is given by the voltage division formula. It is given by R2 upon R1 plus R2 into VCC. So putting these values here, we have to find out the operating point of the circuit. Now to find out the operating point, we have to first apply calculate IB. So apply karenge KVL in the input loop. VCC से RC, बेस RTH, सॉरी लेट अस कैलकुलेट VCE फर्स्ट इन दिस सर्किट. सो आउटपुट लूप केवल इन द आउटपुट लूप, इट विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम VCC कलेक्टर रेजिस्टेंस RC, एमीटर RE. So the equation will be formed. Okay, so the equation will be this. It will be VCC minus the drop in RC minus the drop in collector and emitter junction minus the drop in resistance RE. So VCE will come out to be VCC minus IC RC minus IE RE. So now we will calculate IC and IE. Once I calculate IB and IC, we know what is IE. Let's apply KVL in the input loop. Now input loop will start from VTH. In input loop, we are having VTH. So starting from VTH, RTH, then emitter resistance back to the source is the input loop. So the KVL will be VTH minus IB RTH minus VBE minus IERE is equal to 0. This will be the second equation, and we have calculated IB. With the IB, I can calculate IC, which is equal to beta IB. This is when I got IC and IB, I can calculate VCE, putting the values of IC and IE here. So this is how we can calculate the operating point of this circuit.